Hello there. In this video, we're going to look at how your students or candidates can log in to the AutoProctor test and how these login settings depend on the test type that you've created. Now, you may know that AutoProctor supports different test types. We have our own quizzes called Socratease quizzes that natively integrate with AutoProctor. This gives the best experience for the candidates and test creators. But you can also create a Google form quiz, you can create a Microsoft form quiz, or in fact any other quizzing platform. If you get the URL of the test, you can add that on AutoProctor, right? And so you can, when you're trying to create a test, you have to first choose which test type it is. I've actually gone ahead and created four different tests. You can see iframe test. This iframe test is the other quizzing platform I talked about, Microsoft Forms, Google Forms, and Socratease quiz. Okay, so the tests have been created, and you know that if you copy this, you will get the link that you shared with all your candidates. Now, if you go into the settings of the iframe test, and then you go into the advanced settings, you see here it says login providers, Google, Microsoft, email. Okay, this means if, let's say I copy the link to the test, and I try to log in to the test, right? So I will see here it says sign in with Google, sign in with Microsoft, and sign in with email. So with the iframe test, you decide which of the different login methods you want to enable, right? You must enable at least one, but you decide which of the login methods. So if I save this now, and if I open the link again, you see there's only sign in with Google because that is the only method that's enabled. If I go back and I choose the Microsoft Forms test, right? I go into settings and I go into advanced settings. I do not see the option of the login method, right? That's because if you're using a Microsoft Forms test, the only way you can log in is via Microsoft. So you can sign with Microsoft. The user needs to have a Microsoft account for them to take the Microsoft Forms test on AutoProctor, right? Because that's the only option available, you can't select anything here. The same holds true for Google Forms. If it's a Google Forms test, if I go into settings, I will see that there is no option to select the login method. Okay. Again, if I copy the link and if I try accessing the test, you see there's only sign in with Google. Okay, I cannot sign in with any other method. Socratease quizzes are like iframe tests in that you can again select which option, select one of the options for the providers, right? So whatever you enable is what the candidate will see. Now, there is no way that a candidate can attempt the test without logging in. Okay, if you decide to disable all three, if I go into settings and if I say I don't want to have any of these, right, and you save it, now you may think, okay, maybe there's no login at all. That's not true. All three will be shown. Okay, so if you disable all three will be shown. So there must be a way when you share the link with the candidate, there must be some way for us to track the submission, right? If there are 10 candidates who submit, we need to know who, we get 10 submissions, we need to be able to map the submission to the candidate. And the way we do that is via them logging in with an account, okay? So you cannot do away with logging in. All candidates must log in, but depending on the test type, so if you have the iframe test or the Socratease quiz, you can decide what methods to use. The simplest thing would be, if you're unsure about this, pick the Socratease quiz and enable login with email, because most candidates or students should have some form of an email. So even if you're not using Google or Microsoft, you can say sign in with email, and then they'll be signed with email. All right. You can of course enable all three, and then they can choose what they want to sign in with. That it doesn't really matter. But if you're using Microsoft Forms, it's only Microsoft login, and Google Forms is only Google login. All right. Thank you.